गुड मॉर्निंग. टुडे वी हैव अ वेल नोन डिग्निटरी फ्रॉम एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट, डॉक्टर सुग्रीव सिंह कुशवा. सो डॉक्टर कुशवा इज अ वाइस चांसलर एट सर्वपाली राधाकृष्णा यूनिवर्सिटी. ग्रीटिंग्स फ्रॉम कॉलेज दुनिया सर.
थैंक यू वेरी मच
सर. आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू फ्यू क्वेश्चन. सर, व्हाट डू यू थिंक योर रोल एंड रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज टू द यूनिवर्सिटीज एंड फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स आर?
ओके, इफ यू सी माय यूनिवर्सिटी, बिकॉज I am a medical graduate and then a medical postgraduate, but my university had got all the technical courses. And the mission of my university, that is the Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, is we create the students not a job seeker, but they at the end of the course, they should become a job creator. So my main emphasis is on the skill development over the
ओके सर. सर, लाइक जैसे कि आप वाइस चांसलर हैं सर्वपाली राधाकृष्ण यूनिवर्सिटी के, तो आपकी लीडरशिप स्टाइल क्या है और आप कौन सी स्टाइल यूज करते हैं रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन?
नहीं, आई नेवर से माय सेल्फ ए लीडर, बट आई ऑलवेज से आई एम वन ऑफ द टीम मेंबर एंड आई बिलीव इन द मैनेजमेंट नॉट इन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. सो माय मेन मोटो एंड एम बोथ that I should be part of the team and I should encourage the good things. At the same time, I should warn my team members that we are away from your goal. So my goal are well defined and it is an endeavor of the each team member. One side team member means anyone who enters in the university become my member. So my team is entire university. And each one of them is contributing for this development of the university.
So this is very, very nice. You are like taking everyone with you. This is
okay,
very good.
Sure.
Sir, like what do you think should be a university's top priority in next 10 years?
If you see from the today scenario that the government of India has announced the National Education Policy 2020. And the National Education Policy envisages the inculcation of the student in both the ways, in the gaining the knowledge, but from the sixth class onwards, it is equally important for the skill development. And it is my earnest desire, and it will be my newer goal that we should be adhere to this new education policy. And this new education policy is, we can say, it runs parallel to my university goals also. Because the main emphasis over the knowledge plus the skill. And our university, because we have got the engineering courses, management courses, then we have got the pharmacy courses, then we have got the nursing courses, paramedical courses, or you can say homeopathy courses, dental courses, and of course, and all the medical courses. So you can say all the technical courses. So this is more a technical university, and our emphasis that our students should be much more, they should be knowledgeable, at the same time they should be skilled so that they can impart and they can perform their duty at the utmost.
This is very nice, sir. Sir, like when you first came to Sarvapalli University, what was your vision that you came?
Actually, if you ask me very truly, because right from the beginning, my childhood, I entered in the School of the Medicine at Gajanan Raja Medical College, Gwalior. From where I learned my graduation, which is known as MBBS. Then subsequently, with the God's grace, I got the postgraduation in those days where it was very impossible. Then I did my postgraduation, then subsequently persuaded by career. Both way, as a teacher and as an epidemiologist, or you can say much more a researcher. Then subsequently, over the age, I had given the responsibility of this managing the hospital. Then subsequently managing a college as a dean. Then I become the director of the medical education for the government of the Madhya Pradesh. From there, I become the vice chancellor. this is, you can say, a continuation of my journey.
Mm-hmm.
And during this period, I found, because during my, you can say, teaching days, or you can say my late days of the professorship, I was this exposed to the different capacity of the university working. So from there, I said that it was my vision that I should join some university, and if I can contribute in the different specialty for the development as a student, it will be fulfilling my desire, and it will be giving me a sense of gratitude to the God. And when I entered to this university, I make it be sure that I should contribute to the students, and I would contribute to the university. So I become a part and parcel of the students most of the time, whether they are with the curricular activity or from the extracurricular activity. And that gave me the confidence, and that given the confidence to the student that he is one of us. So it is given me always a plus point for this, for smooth working of this college.
Very nice journey you have, sir. Like, from a very basics to a very good position, you have succeeded in every sector. It's very good, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, like, what do you think people should know about your university that they are not aware about, that they may not know?
It is by all means that because this world is too small, and every city is too larger. It is desired that my university should come at par with the other university at the national level, and it is my earnest desired and effort that it comes at par with the global university in the both in the education, in the research, and in the skill formation. And my university started in the 2014 with this by this gazette of the government of the Madhya Pradesh, because it is a mandate in the state of the Madhya Pradesh that the university can only start by the permission of the government, and it is regulated by the one agency, which is known as MP, Private University Regulatory Commission. So it is regulated, and we are fulfilling all the mandate and all the rules and regulations given by the university. And within the short span of the, you can say, 5 years or the 6 years, if you see my students, they can be seen in part in all corners of the India, as well as in all corner of the world, working in the different capacity and working in the different portion of the world. So I further say that if I can, and I will also, that it should come with this national, it should be at par with the national university, not below the national university.
Very nice, sir. Like, Sarvapalli University gives a 360 degree education in technical also.
Sure.
Yeah.
So because it is thinking, once you, because it is said that once you look behind, more times you look forward. So from the lesson of our past, we always see for the future, and how to design the future in the newer scenario. It is a part of the each and every faculty member and each and every working in the university, that what would be the future of the university, and I foresee that the future of the university will be very bright.
So true. Sir, any suggestion you would like to give to your current youth and current aspirant, to the aspirant student?
I will say that both ways. They should see my website. And above all, they should come to the university. They should meet their peers, the studying student. They should see the both internal and external environment of the university. I will further say that they should come and see our laboratory, different laboratories of the different subjects. And then they should say, and it is also said, one of the, if the student says that we require this type of the laboratory, we are always open that the things should be made available, it is within our resources and within our emblem of the university.
Very nice, sir. Like Sarvapalli University is keeping transparency to the student and department as well. Good, sir.
And that's why if you say that we have got this, all the type of the graduate engineering courses like B.Tech in the in health defense specialty, then M.Tech, then we have got the PhD in the engineering, we have got the computer scientist. Both graduate computer sciences, postgraduate computer sciences, and doctorate in the computer sciences. Then we have got the different type of the courses of the nursing sciences, right from the diploma, that is the GNM, BSc nursing, post BSc nursing, MSc nursing, and PhD nursing. Then about 25-26 different type of the paramedical courses. Both graduate courses. We have this, from this year we are starting the postgraduate courses. Plus the diploma course. So these paramedical courses, they are fully devoted to the skill development. And they are mostly for the job oriented. Then the pharmacy courses, diploma pharmacy courses, degree pharmacy courses, postgraduate pharmacy, like M Pharma, PhD. Then we are the fortunate to have this BDS, MDS. Then the homeopathy graduate, and our college is a, we can say it is a, you people like this, that we have got the MD in the homeopathy in the eight subject. Then we have got the, you can say the scenario of the all the type of the courses.
Yes, sir.
So on behalf of you, and I see that you give the students that my website, and you can say the line is open 24/7 for the students. And because now it is, they can come. If the seat will be available, it is first come, first served, according to this. Because we never compromise the merit and we never compromise the government guidelines. Whatever the government, whether they are the, because my university is governed by this rule of the nation, rule of the state, because till now the education is a state policy. So whatever this admission policy, we are aware to it. For an exam, MBBS, we only take from the NEET and by the state government. For this, you can say BDS, by the NEET qualified, and they are allotted by the state government. Similarly for the different Indian courses. So door are open to everybody, but within the framework of the rule or the law.
So that is very nice, sir. Thank you so much for your valuable
time. Thank you very much for giving the time and the opportunity to say a few words about my university.
Thank you so much for the invitation, sir. I totally, I'm very happy that like a dignity like you giving me an invitation. And thank you so much, sir, giving your valuable time, taking time for us.
Thank you.